of external static and universal selector. Okay. I just make a small web page over here. I am taking the style tag, and the type attribute of style tag has the value text or CSS, and I close here the head tag. This was the concept of internal style. Internal style, as you know, that we are to apply the style rules on all the possible selectors inside the style tag, which I have taken inside the head tag. Here the style is working as tag. When we were in the inline style, the style was working as an attribute. Okay, clear? Suppose I have created a small code over here. Welcome students. Then using H3 to offline classes and H3 closes. Okay. So I have taken two tags. One is H1, in which I have typed the text welcome students, and in the H3 tag I have type the text to offline class. Right? This is the simplest coding which I have created. Now I am to format, I am to apply the style rules on them. So I click here. First of all, I want to apply the style rule in the body selector. Don't put angle brackets over here. I am putting the background color forest green. This is the background color of the web page, right? Then I am to apply the properties on H1 selector. The properties which I want to apply on H1 selector: font family, Arial, color yellow, font size pixels, right? Font size 70 pixels, font style italic. These are the properties I want to apply on H1. Am I clear up till here, online class? Hasita, Vanita, Prabhjot. Prabhjot, 33 roll number. Jia. Harleen. Now, next is H3. In H3, I want to apply the properties. Same properties, I copy paste here and I'll make some changes over here. Like font family, I'm taking here Rockwell. Color, I am taking here blue. Font size, I am taking 50, and I don't want italic, so I'm removing this property. These are all the possible style rules I want to apply to my selector. Okay. This was my internal style sheet. If in board examination, CBSE gives you one code and CBSE demands that as a computer programmer, create the CSS section to apply the given properties on to the selectors using internal style sheet. CBSE is not asking for the complete web page. CBSE is asking only for the coding part. Parikshit, we are studying in the lab. What you are supposed to do, you are not to make this entire coding. Your coding part will be just this much, which I have shaded. Because only CSS portion has been asked. And that too, CBSE has told you to use internal style sheet. If the question is silent, no inline, no internal, no external, then you are free to use any method. Okay. But if particular method has been given, then you have to apply that method only. Okay. So this was your internal style. Now internal here, I just close the style tag here. One thing you might have noticed while I was typing this code, I have not made any other separate file. I am in the same page. In the same page, I did the CSS coding. In the same page, I did the HTML coding. I have not made any special separate page for the style rules. Main usi page ke andar hun. I am in the same page. Got it? Am I clear up till here? Offline class? Online class, am I clear up till here? Sayam, Mehak. Okay. So I save this web page. I show the output once. Then I will make changes for the external style sheet here. I am giving the name 10d.off.html. Let us see the browser view of it. In the document section, I have to go 10d off. This is your file. Open with Google Chrome. See the output. See the browser view. Am I clear up till here? Daksh, your class is in front, not at the back. And shift your seat there. I told you. Shift there. Clear? Any questions, any queries? Online class, any queries? Shall I proceed further? I think AC is disturbing you. Now, see what I'm going to do. That will be the start of external style sheet. External. We will make two files. One file, we'll be doing HTML coding, this part. The second file, where we will be typing only the CSS portion, this portion. Two separate files, one HTML, one CSS. Then using the link tag, we will be correlating, we will be associating the two files together. Before CSS, you people have done link attribute in body tag to specify the color of hyperlink. Now you will study link tag. In the previous year pre-board, there was one question of 1 mark in the case study. Differentiate between link attribute and link tag. Okay. I make a second version of this file and I give the name the external dot html. Okay, clear? Now I copy, cut paste this portion. I create another file and I paste it over here. Okay. You get to know what I have done. And I'm saving this file in documents with the name coding.css. Here, notice only the selector name is there and only the properties are there. I have not used HTML tag, head tag, body tag, then closing tags. Is page mein sirf aur sirf style rules apply ho rahe hain, sirf properties apply ho rahi hain. You get to know it. And I have saved this file with the name coding.css. Now I have to open my previous file. My previous file was this. I open the coding of this file. Here I will do the normal HTML coding. But I have to create the link between CSS file and HTML file. So I'll be taking link tag. It's not visible. You can come here. You come and sit here. No, come here. Hurry up, be fast. Shh. Recording is going on. Link tag, first attribute is REL. REL means relation. The relation of the external file to our file is of style sheet. So the value of this attribute will be style sheet. Okay. I just reduced the size of the text. Then the type of the file is text or CSS. href attribute that will help us to jump to the external file, that will help us to connect to the external file. And href attribute will take the value, the name of CSS file. The value of href attribute will be the name of CSS file, the same name with which you save the CSS file. This is your link tag. Clear? Am I clear? Now I save this file and let us check the browser view. See the output. See the browser view. This is external style sheet. I will do some changes here because right now I have just cut paste the properties. So you are noticing the same colors. Now, suppose you want to change the properties. You want to change the properties. You are to make change only in the CSS portion. You are not to make any changes in the HTML file. If any property you want to change, you have to make changes only in the CSS portion. Like you don't want italic. Okay. You want to display it in lowercase text transform lowercase. Okay. See, you want to bring the heading in the center. Again, open the CSS file. Property to bring data in the center is text align colon center. Clear? Any doubt up till here? Because next concept I'm going to end it up. Okay. Suppose you have 5-6 lines where you want to apply the yellow color to the text. Suppose I have H4 here, school starts classes today. हम एक और H4 टैग ऐड कर रहे हैं, ठीक है? And let me do the CSS coding for this file. I am here. H4. I want the font हटाना है. Want the font size 40 pixels. Okay. I want color as red. Clear? Got it? Now the question is, I want the entire text in the web page should be of yellow color. अभी आपके सामने एक लाइन येलो है, एक ब्लू, एक रेड है. आई वॉन्ट द एंटायर टेक्स्ट टू बी इन येलो कलर. यू हैव वन ऑप्शन एज यू माइट बी थिंकिंग राइट नाउ दैट चेंज द कलर येलो एवरीवेयर वी हैव टेकन द कलर प्रॉपर्टी. Everywhere we have taken the color property, change the color to yellow. Suppose you have 15 sentences. 15 times you will change the color yellow, color yellow, color yellow. Same property to be applied on entire page, but 15 times you have to repeat the property. To avoid this problem, we have a feature in the CSS called Universal Selector. Universal Selector means to apply the property that will be common to the entire page, to all the elements in the page. It will be applicable to the entire elements you have taken in the web page. You just have to write it once. It will be applicable automatically to the entire page. How it is denoted? How to represent universal selector? By putting star, what you call asterisk. Okay? Curly bracket. Color yellow. All the properties that you want common in the web page, put them inside the universal selector. Instead, you type it again and again, only one time, put the property inside the universal selector. It will be automatically applied to the entire page. Got it? I want all the lines to come in the center. So instead to apply text align center here individually, you put inside the universal selector. Got the concept? So how it is represented? Universal selector is represented by asterisk star. This you will find above on the 8 number key. 8 number key. Shift press karke aayega ye. Got it? Okay, now I have few questions, then we disperse the class. Dash is the property used for setting the font of the text. Font family. Dash is the extension of CSS file. .css. Dash is the extension of HTML file. Dash, dash, and dash are three methods to apply the style rules. Inline, internal, external. Inline, internal, external. Okay. Dash, dash, and dash are three attributes of link tag. REL, type, HREL. REL, type, and HREL. Okay. Okay. Name any three type of border styles. In the last lecture, we discussed border property. Tell me three styles of the border. I revise the border property again with you. Border has three properties. Border width. I am taking 7 pixels. Border color, I am taking red. Border style, ridge or dotted or dashed or groove or inset or outset. Clear? See, welcome students is now displayed inside the border. So what are the different border styles? Ridge, groove, dashed, dotted, inset, outset. What are the three properties related to border? Border width, border style, border color. Okay, name four properties related to font. Font, it is not font color, it is only color. Font family, font style, font weight, font variant. Font variant. Okay. Clear? Font style, font weight, font variant, font family. Name four properties related to text. Text align, text transform, text indent, text decorative. Okay, clear? Dash helps to apply the same property to all the elements of web page. Universal selector.
universal selector. Okay, what is the full form of CSS? Cascading style sheet. Cascading style sheet. In which style sheet, style is used as an attribute inside the opening tag? In the inline style. In which style sheet, style is used as a tag? Internal. Okay, internal style sheet. Okay. How can we set the size 50 to our text in CSS? Font colon size, font hyphen size colon 50 pixels. PX means pixels. Online class, am I clear up till here with all the questions? Hasita, Bissam, Vanita. All right, MCQ type questions. Those who know, just raise the hand. From the given options, pick out the odd one out. Font family, font size, font variant, face. I said, just raise your hand. Face. Face is attribute used inside the HTML font tag. Above three are the properties. Second, which of the following property is invalid? I write here, font family Rockwell, font family Rockwell, font size 60 pixels, text in line right. These are your options. Tell me the invalid property. Yes, Prikshit. A option. Font without any hyphen. Your all properties in CSS are hyphenated. So this is the inappropriate. Okay. Okay. Next MCQ. Which symbol is used in CSS to specify the value to the property? Daksh. Colon, the first option. Okay, same options. Which symbol is used in order to separate the properties? Wait, wait. Let me ask from the online class. Tanya, yes, unmute yourself.
Sir, semicolon.
Semicolon, the second option. Very right. Clear?